give the ranch and Steve and Barnes for helping organize this. Just a great big Titan. Thank you. A round of applause. The dinner was fabulous. I know I can speak for everybody in the room, and I'm pretty sure I can speak for everybody in Granite County. The players, the coaches, the fans. We'd like to thank all those that helped, you know, make this 2017-2018 football season, you know, a dream come true. First of all, I'd like to show there's a ton of respect and thanks that needs to go out to these young student athletes for their dedication, their hard work, and the effort that they put into this football season. The pride that they brought to Granite County is immeasurable. It was amazing. You know, you've earned the respect of everybody, not only throughout Granite County, but throughout the state of Montana. You put, you know, the Flint Creek Titans on the map. You know, your hard work, your unity, your toughness, your discipline showed through this year all the way to the fourth quarter of the state championship game. It was truly amazing and an honor to watch you guys play. Our coaches, thank you to our coaches for their commitment, hard work, focus on the student part. Not only do they lead practices, drills, weight room, film sessions, you name it, they offer wisdom, they offer care and guidance both on and off the playing field. I don't think there's any question, I don't think there's any doubt that we have the absolute best coaching staff in the state of Montana. Bar none. Thank you. I also think we have the best fans and parents in Montana as well. They stand behind our hardworking student athletes. They show a support system and a true commitment to our kids that play high school sports. They volunteer for big roles, for small roles. They show up to games and they cheered our kids on with a ton of team spirit, and it was amazing. So thank you, parents. Last but not least, I'd like to thank, Sarah Wagner, the numerous volunteers, booster clubs from each school, parents. They enabled us to have the best facilities in the state of Montana, and they also they fed you guys the best home-cooked meals ever, right? Yeah. Okay. It can be easy to overlook, all the people that were behind the scenes. It would surprise all you players just how many people volunteered their personal time and their resources to make this season so, so special. If I were to do a list, I'd miss somebody, but it was well over 100 people that helped make all this, helped you guys, and it was just an amazing, amazing season. So everybody that was involved with with the Granite County and Flint Creek the football season this year, give yourself a round of applause because it was truly a once-in-a-lifetime team, and we're just unbelievably proud of everybody involved. So thank you. I'd like to thank number 11, Colton Strange, put this slideshow together. He did it last minute, so whenever we come, that is the...
Sweat and blood. Give away those gang their jerseys down the hall. Kings of the school, man, where the boys are fall.
Schools and, you know, especially this last fall with everything that he's done in the football programs. Thanks, Tim.
Thank you.
All right, it's my great pleasure to introduce our guest speaker this evening. We're honored to have Jeff Choate and his wife Janet with us this evening. Coach Choate played football at Montana Western in Dillon, graduated with a bachelor's degree in secondary education in 1993, his college collegiate playing, and he also coached alongside Coach Cutler at Western. He played with him, and then he was his linebacker's coach. And so they go way back, so it's just an honor to have him here tonight. Before coaching at the collegiate level, he began a high school coaching career in Idaho. He became the head football and track coach at Challis, Idaho from 1994 to 1996. He was an assistant football, wrestling, and baseball coach at Twin Falls High School in Idaho, 96 and 97. He was the athletic director, head football coach at Post Falls High School from 1997 to 2002. The Division I chapter of Coach Choate's coaching career began in 2002 at Utah State, where he coached the defensive line and special teams, defensive line, and safeties from 2003 to 2004. He coordinated special teams and coached safeties at Eastern Illinois in 05 and 06 before he returned to Idaho. And there he worked as special teams coordinator from 2006 to 2011. He was a defensive run game coordinator and linebackers coach at Washington State in 2012. And after a brief stint at UTEP in the spring of 2013, he moved to Florida, where he coordinated special teams and coached outside linebackers. The next season, he took over the special teams and the defensive line duties at the University of Washington for the Huskies, where he coached in 2014-2015. So without further ado, it is my great pleasure to introduce the head coach of the Montana State Fighting Bobcats, Jeff Choate.
He may talk longer introducing me than I'm going to talk tonight. So, but I tell you what, that's a lot of moves. Thanks for hanging in there with me, Janet. I appreciate it. Unbelievably humbled to be here tonight. Unbelievably humbled. You know, when Coach Cutler called me up and asked if I'd be willing to do this, a busy time of year, I said, I'll make time for it. And that's going to explain my message, I think, when we get full circle. But the slideshow at the end there, when it said 22 players, two schools, I was thinking two towns, two communities. I asked Mike 100 questions, I think, when I got here tonight about how'd you make this work? You know, 4 years ago when this vision of coming together and putting this co-op together, and how these two communities have really kind of, this has become the pride of Granite County. I don't think this can work everywhere. I think this is a special group. And it's an honor to be here tonight and share a couple of things with you. You know, one of the things that I was going to talk about was just what an unbelievable experience high school football is. I don't think you guys fully understand this, but I think parents in the room, and congratulations to you for raising these fine young men. You get this. This is one of the last proving grounds for young men left. You know, basketball, you sit in a nice, cozy gymnasium and shoot baskets. You know, you guys got to go out there in the mud and the muck. You got to do it when you don't feel like doing it. You got to show up in the summer. You guys have responsibilities and obligations outside of this, but I'm guessing this championship wasn't won starting in August. This thing was won with all the time and effort and energy that you put in prior to that, because that's how championships are won. And probably the most important thing that happened through that process for each one of you was that you learned to love each other and care about each other and realize that the team is what this is about. Having the ability to kind of suppress some selfish feelings that all of us have, because that's human nature. There's only one football. Not everybody's going to get the picture in the paper. But that didn't matter. What mattered was the team. And I know Coach Cutler shared some of those things with me, and there's no doubt about that. And I've done this a long time, and I've had the good fortune to be a part of some amazing teams. And what I've learned is that there's really only three types of teams. There's only three types of teams. There's a team in name only, meaning that everybody wears the jersey. They got the name on the front, but they don't care about each other. They go to practice. They go to the locker room. They leave. Those teams usually aren't very successful. There's a team in action, which is what most teams are. Most teams kind of are working towards something, right? They win some, they lose some. There's some great moments. There's some disappointing moments. They care about each other. They want to be good. And that's what most teams are trying to do. And then every once in a while, very, very rarely, I can count on one hand the number of teams that I've been a part of that are like this. And what this team is a team of legacy. And that's what we all strive for in my profession as coaches. We want to be a part of teams of legacy. Because forever, they're going to talk about the 2017 Flint Creek Titans. You guys played a game against Forsyth a little while ago that was a forever game. A forever game. You will have that forever. And that is unique, and that is special, and that is something that will never go away from you. And the cool thing about that is this, and the older people in this room will understand this more than you will, but someday you might. The older you get, the more you're going to need the people that knew you when you were young. The older you get, the more you're going to need the people that knew you when you were young. Because life will beat you up. It's not always going to be state championships. But the guy to the lefty and the guy to the righty right now, that's how they'll always remember you. And that's unique and special. And I just think that you guys have got to embrace that and appreciate that. One of the hallmarks of our program at Montana State, one of the things that I hope that we're imparting to our young men is the concept of toughness. And I think about, and I'm not talking about fistfight toughness. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm not talking about the guy that can hit the hardest on the football field. That is not even close to what I'm talking about. I'm talking about having the ability to take an emotional blow and respond quickly and appropriately without losing your cool. I'm talking about understanding the difference between problems and real problems. And when I think about toughness, I think about two of your coaches. I think about two of your coaches. One of them I've known since I was your age. That understand, they exemplify what toughness is to me. And I think you guys are really fortunate to have Coach Holland and Coach Cutler. And men that I respect tremendously, that I look up to. And so, what an unbelievable opportunity you've had there. I'm going to leave you with a poem that is totally plagiarized 100%. It's not an original word. I know you guys are looking at me thinking, I'm probably like, you know, a lot of sonnets or something, doesn't it? I am a Western grad, so, you know, at least, I don't know if they actually, I might probably graduated from there. I think they gave me like a bus ticket and told me to get the heck out of town. You know, 30 years later, they let me back in Montana, which was cool. So, but the title of this is Everything I Ever Needed to Know About Life, I Learned in Football. And so if you'll just let me read this to you real quick, and I think there'll be some things that maybe you'll stick with you, and we'll kind of go from there. I didn't find wisdom at the top of my graduate school mountain, but out on the practice and game field. And these are the things I learned. Share the pain and the triumphs. Play by the rules. Leave the program better than when you entered it. Give your teammates the credit due to them when you were praised for team accomplishments. Care about the well-being of your opponent. Hard work and sweat are good for you. Live a balanced life. Learn all you can. Think before you say or do. Enjoy the process as well as the victories. Have fun and get better every day. And then take a break now and then. When you meet a superior opponent, hold hands with your teammate and work together. That's the only way you can win. Believe in your teammates. Don't try to do his job or your job will suffer. Maximum achievement is based on hard work and sacrifice. Remember, the coach is not out to hurt anyone and always wants what's best for the team. Football is only a game. Everybody loses, not just you. And defeat is never fatal or final unless you allow it to be that way. The first and most important thing that you need to learn is attitude. There's always a way to get your job done, even if your problem is bigger, stronger, or faster than you are. Take any one of these items and apply it to your world, your job, your family, your relationships, our nation. and think about what a better place it would be if we went out and practiced those every day at 3 o'clock. And then throughout the rest of the year as well. We live in a world that needs hard work, teamwork, and sacrifice. Trust in your teammates and remember that no matter how old you are, it will always be your attitude and not the number of wins and losses that reflect your quality of life. And I think the last thing that I want to leave you with is this. You have inspired a lot of people, whether you know it or not. You can see the pride in this community. I know one of our assistant coaches would write you guys every week. We follow you. Circle game, a bunch of Coach Cutler's old teammates and some coaches were there to watch you. Believe it or not, there's a lot of people that were watching you and pulling for you because you could feel that this was something special and unique. And so I hope that you guys can embrace this, wrap it up, tuck it in your pocket. And when life does beat you up a little bit, look back on it. Remember the guys that knew you when you were young. Thank you for inspiring so many people. Thank you for your hard work and dedication. Congratulations on an unbelievable achievement. And proud to be here tonight. Thank you guys and best of luck.
J.C. Hall.
Thanks again, guys. I know I'll forget to thank some people tonight. First, I got to thank Shelly, my wife, and my kids. They sacrificed a pile just to keep me going every day, get me in and out of the door. Shuffling wheelchairs around, it's like a circus sometimes at the games. State championship game, the one wheelchair is going dead, and get the other one up here, and then I holler at her, get it behind the fence. So, thank you, Shelly, and Luke, Kayla. One thing is, and I know Coach Cutler will probably talk about the same thing, two of our assistant coaches, Nate and Ryder. These two guys are awesome. We've got an offensive line coach and a D-line coach. Never had it before. And it is huge. I mean, every game we go into, we make a joke. How big our nose guard is, how big our center is. They outweigh us by 250 pounds this week. We just make a joke of it. Because we know their technique's right, they're going to get it done. It's just been a huge asset to this team, both Riley and Nate. So give them a round again, please. The other group of kids is our younger kids that played JVs this year. One of the things that we wanted to start with this co-op is to allow our young kids to grow up and play JV football before they ever had to play varsity football. You don't have good programs when you're starting two freshmen every year, two sophomores. It doesn't happen. The good programs let those kids grow up. Some of them are mature. Some of them are ready to play as freshmen and sophomore, but a lot of them aren't. And sometimes it's tough on a kid to play. Petey Carrillo, one of the best players I've ever coached, never saw the field until he was a junior. But he learned as a freshman and sophomore, and it's huge to have the numbers that we have. Without this, we don't. We're going to be playing freshmen and sophomore. So these younger guys, the freshmen and sophomores and maybe some juniors, whatever, we've had a young team the last couple of years. So maybe it's been frustrating to you. And you young guys know you were challenged a lot this year, weren't you, in practice? Had a couple practices, maybe the varsity's done, and we kept the younger kids there, and we had a little bloodbath at the end of practice, didn't we? Blood and guts for about 15, 20 minutes, see who the toughest was, right? Well, it's going to pay off. And I'll guarantee you, because we still have some younger kids coming back, we don't have a lot of seniors, nobody in the state of Montana wants to play our JVs next year in football. I'll guarantee you. Because they're going to get their ass kicked. So, you young guys, thank you. Because it's not easy when it's 10 degrees out. We got the lights on in the field. You guys are out there being a tackling dummy, maybe for some of the older kids. It's not easy. It's not always fun. But you guys got a month more football this year than almost any team in the state. Okay? So use that for next year. And thank you, young guys, again. Give them a round, please. And as far as the older kids go, just thank you guys for everything you did for us as coaches. Never had one issue that I could think of this year where anytime we asked anything of you, there was never a rolled eye, never a bat of an eye, you just did it. Okay? It's huge. And, I mean, you guys won't know what that means to us coaches to get to deal with a group of kids like you guys. It's huge. Zero issues, nothing but teamwork, nothing but one team. It was one heartbeat the whole year with you guys. And it's huge for us coaches. That's the last thing we need to worry about is team chemistry or something like that. We didn't have to worry about it. All we did is went to coach. Okay? And then you guys get the spoils now. All that hard work, all that dedication, all that teamwork, now you're getting to enjoy it. And enjoy it. One thing Don Anderson said, I remember after the first one we won, enjoy this, but don't let this be the best thing that ever happened to you in your life. Don't settle for this. You want to win another one. You want to be a good father. You want to be something like that. Don't let this be the best thing, but enjoy the heck out of it, okay? So this is to our older kids. Some of them are leaving. We got three seniors. You know, we're going to be gone. Two of them were 4 years part of this. Rocco missed a year because of a skateboarding accident. If he'd had all that hair, he probably wouldn't have got a concussion. But you three seniors, thank you. It's been a pleasure all 4 years coaching you guys. You weren't the biggest, you weren't the strongest, you weren't the fastest, but you got it done, didn't you? And it's because of teamwork and dedication. So thank you, three seniors. All right, we're going to miss you. I got to thank Coach Cutler. I watch an obscene amount of game film, which is stupid and ridiculous. This huddle and bin swap is just the dumbest freaking thing they ever came up with in the world. You can sit at home and watch endless hours of game film. No more DVD, no more VCR, all that crap. And I don't watch a tenth of what Coach Cutler watches. You guys have no idea how prepared you guys are as a team every week when you guys go to play. I make a rule on myself as doing the defense. I watch enough until I come up with our game plan and I quit because I find myself trying to predict what play they're going to run and taking you guys out of positions to make a play. Offensively, he made a game plan, and these three playoff games were incredible. I don't think you guys know how much time and effort he put into that. He was 10 plays ahead of foresight on offense. And someday you guys will realize it, but it was truly amazing what he did this year. And I want to thank Mike. Thank you. Last thing, this team reminds me of another team we coached in Drummond, and I hate to bring that up because we are a co-op, but this just reminds me of this. I don't know if you guys know Buzz and Nedra Weston from Deer Lodge. They're, you probably know their son, Steve Weston, is a basketball official, looks like the most intense man in the world. You guys all know Steve, he's a football coach in Hamilton, and his family has got the same intensity that he does. Well, his mom sends me a card before one of our state championships in Drummond. And on the outside of the card, it's got a picture of a guy sitting on a dock in a lawn chair, drinking a cold drink with a fishing pole, got his pole in the water, kind of half asleep, half awake. And on the outside of the card, it says, good things happen to those that sit and wait. Okay, that's pretty cool. You open the card up on the inside, it's a guy sitting in a boat, full of fish, fish running over the side of the boat, just completely full, throwing sticks of dynamite in the water. And on the inside, it says, great things happen to those that get off their ass and make it happen. Well, and that's you guys, all right? Thanks, everybody in both communities. Thank you, guys.
Cutler and Mr. Holland, this was kind of their, you know, they got together 4 years ago and visited about, you know, the big picture with...
10 years ago, Dustin.
Ten years ago. And so obviously it's come to fruition, but the amount of dedication that, you know, all four coaches and, you know, but I know that Coach Cutler and Coach Holland, you know, just put their heart and soul into this program and it is so, it's unbelievable that the first, you know, these three seniors, they're the first four-year Titans. And, you know, and as one of the basketball coaches from Phillipsburg, this works. I mean, and the way I'm going to say this is at the tip-off tournament last weekend, you know, the Drummond kids sat behind our bench when we played, and our kids sat behind Drummond's bench when they played because they're family now. And I just can't see that changing. The amount of respect, and I'll use the word brotherhood, because you just see that with these kids. And I'm not just going to go on and on for the rest of their lives. And so, but and this all started with you know, Coach Holland and Coach Cutler. And it's just, you know, my great pleasure. And I think he's also you know, a Hall of Fame coach. He's, you know, he's the most intense, kind-hearted, soft-hearted guy you will ever meet, and I just think you guys are so, so fortunate to have this guy who's brought this county together. Mike Cutler, get up here.
Remember the state championship, but they're also going to remember this thing. And we put a lot of work into this, and it's not over. I spent a lot of time yesterday preparing for this, and it's going to be long, but it's going to be memorable. And I'm going to ask you guys one question. How would you like to play for Jeff Choate? You think I'm intense? Take a look at him. You know, he was just trying to congratulate you, for crying out loud. I got to play alongside of him. Him and I battled a lot when we were freshmen because he played defense and I was the running back. And then I got to play for him. You know, Jeff had an accident, vehicle accident, and it kind of ended his career. But look what path he's on now. He's the head football coach at MSU. So I got to play for him for a year too. And that's a year I'll never forget. I remember writing him a card after the season and how much he meant to me as a coach. And I'm hoping that someday you guys will feel the same way about us as I do about Jeff. So thanks, Jeff. I know you just got off the plane, been all over the place. The National Signing Day's the 20th, And I can't tell you how appreciative I am for you to be here. I know you had to rearrange flights, recruits that you should be in their house tonight, so it means a lot for me to for you to be here. And Janet, it's always a pleasure to be with you. Before I go on my tangent here as I get my glasses, I told you I was going to need one.
I can't see the lights.
But Jackson said it's okay to cry. You know, Jackson's the only one that could probably say that the way Jackson said it. I introduced Jackson to Coach Choate just about a half hour ago, and I said, Jackson, you don't even know who this gentleman is, do you? Nope. Jackson, you know who he is now, don't you? Okay. Before I go into a bunch of stuff, I want to ask you, as fans, how much fun did we have on November 18th at 1 o'clock? Wouldn't want it any other way, right? Before I forget, there's a bunch of things up here on the table for mini state trophies for your kids. There's the program of tonight, and then the gear and championship coats and stuff that you can order from Heritage. I will say that she's not, doesn't have a lot of inventory in stock and doesn't want to. So if you don't like what you see on this form, you can bring her a jacket or whatever you'd like and she'll print that stuff on it. I would like to see state championships on, get jackets on everyone. And if you can't get one, I'll get it for you. Okay? But anyway, I want to thank Tim for all the pictures. Brooks Phillips, all the pictures. It just unbelievable the amount of pictures and photographs that are out there for these kids. Coach Choate talked about team, and you guys have heard this and heard this and heard this because that's all I talk about. That's all Coach Holland talks about. That's all Coach Bignell, Coach Biggie, and Coach Shell talked about this team. There's not one person on this team, including myself, that's bigger than the team. Some of you guys know what I'm about to show you. Anyway, Brooks Phillips got this for me because all the pictures that are on the internet and stuff like that, you know, I want looking through those, and this picture means the most to me than any picture I've seen so far. And basically, it's not the characters that are in the picture, although I do like those two guys. It's what it stands for. There's two communities, two players, and one team. This is right after Colby scored, I think, his second touchdown. Am I right? In the third, fourth quarter, crucial touchdown. And that's what it's about. So I don't know where I'm going to put this. I thank Dean and Brooks for this. I'd like to post it in our log. You know, I don't know. But to me, that's what this whole thing's about, right there. And like I said, it's not about the two guys in it. It's about what that picture stands for. So if you'd like to pass that around and take a look at it, it's pretty special to me. Before I got a lot of thank yous to start with. You know, number one, I'm going to start with JC. Anybody reading Zillion today?
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
How inspirational is that? You know, Coach Choate says, when life gets tough, think about Coach. You know, he wouldn't give you any, he's not going to give you any mercy, would he? What's Coach Holland going to tell you? Suck it up, Buttercup. But JC's been a dear friend of mine forever. And, you know, here we are. And, you know, he says how good, you know, how hard I prepare and the game plans and so on and so forth. But I'm going to talk about it a little bit later. But who had the best defense in the state this year? We did. It's because of him and what he teaches and what our assistant coaches teach and his philosophy about bending and not breaking and discipline with your eyes and your pad level and what shoulder you're attacking and stuff. So I've learned as much from J.C. Holland as I've learned from any coach that I've been around. So thank you, J.C. And then the two guys, Coach Biggie and Coach Bell. I was talking a little earlier about, you know, there was a time where JC and I would blow our court and we're screaming and yelling at the kids, and now we don't necessarily have to do that anymore. There's been multiple times where JC and I look at each other, do we sound like that? So these two guys bring a whole different attitude to this football team. They bring the latest and greatest technique on the offensive and defensive line. Their commitment to JC and I is second to none. Their faithfulness to us. So I can't thank those two enough. JC and I are going to be dead and gone shortly. Who knows? Excuse me. Wow. Not coaching. Our program is in great hands with those two. It's not going anywhere with those two coming up. So thank you. I got to go through these. I want to thank Dustin and Sarah. It's not easy working with us coaches. I know that. We're pretty regimented. We want things to be our way and the only way, and so thank you for putting up with it. I think the end result, I think, you know, we can all be satisfied with it. The co-op board. I'm going to name the co-op board. First of all, I thank both school boards. You know, both school boards had to accept this and make this happen 4 years ago. But the board members that are on the co-op board that put the work, have the meetings. Hasn't been easy. And make the decisions. Come up with the plans and stuff like that that we're following that makes this thing so, run as easy as possible. Leslie Fickler, Robert Garlotti, Leslie DeSantiago, Bob Todorovich, Meredith McDonald, Dustin, Sarah, and Brian Cobb. I can't thank you guys enough. All the moms. Jeez. Did you guys eat like kings or what? You know, it's not easy putting those meals together every night, or, you know, for Thursday nights, and then the breakfast and playoff. You know, as much as you guys learn from us on the football field and listening to Coach Choate, you know, those moms, they're the ones that really take care of you, right? So they need to be thanked. I expect hugs and all those types of things as soon as this is over. Thank you, mothers, ladies. And again, all the volunteers. You know, it wasn't easy clearing those fields. The people that work in the crow's nest, the announcers, all those people. I can't name them all because there's literally 100 of them. But thank you to all those people that had a part. Everybody had a part in what happened on November 18th. And then lastly, I want to thank Jody and Shelly. JC did it, but I'm going to do it again. JC's right. Jody calls herself a football widow when it's football season because that's all I do is watch video and think. And I know JC and Shelly, you know, thanks for your dedication to us. Sydney and Kayla, thank you as well. These are the daughters, our daughters, that kind of get pushed to the side, and it's not intentional. It's just kind of the way it is during football season. So I love you, Kayla, and I love you, Sydney. Thank you. And then Luke and Kate. I got, you know, being coaches, kids. You know what I mean? These guys got coached 24 and a half hours a day. And it's just the way it is being a coach's kid. I know it was tough for both of you at times. Thank you. You guys did great. And it was an honor to be able to coach both of you. let me talk a little bit about our team. We scored 626 points this year. Our varsity kids gave up 76. Who has the best defense in the state? Yeah. Print that. I need you guys, the coaches, come up, please. Help me. Well, now I want to get to the awards. Okay, first of all, we want to do the letter winners. Now, Coach Holland and I talked at length about this when we were together, how we wanted to react to letter winners. You know, in the past, everybody's lettered, and I'm not necessarily against that, but I wanted to bring back the prestige of being a three-year letter winner or a two-year letter winner. So we weren't going to letter everybody going into the season. When our JV beats the crap out of the varsity team, we're lettering everybody on this football team. The letter winners. The first year letter winners, we have a T. Show them the T. Nate, there's an extra one in for you. Okay? Because it's bad or something. So I'm just going to call you up, guys. People that have already got their letters, come up and shake, give the coaches a hug, whatever. Preston Medish, first year letter winner. Really, Preston? Hey, Cutler, first year letter winner. Jackson Lee, second year letter winner. Grange, four-year letter winner. Andrew Gomez, four-year letter winner. Kane Hess, three-year letter winner. Conley Wagner, second year letter winner. Brayden Hubert, second year letter winner. Luke Holland, third year letter winner. Third-year letter winner. First year letter winner. Destin Lynn, first year letter winner. Mason Gray, first year letter winner. Bradley Anderson, first year letter winner. Next year's kicker. Who wants to be a champion?
Who?
I do. Bryce Barrett, first year letter winner. Nate Brashear, third year letter winner. Yes, there's an excellent. Daniel Brabender, second year letter winner. Riley Trogdon, first year letter winner. Riley Allen, third year letter winner. Wyatt Rigby, second year letter winner. Alec Hoffman, first year letter winner. Anthony Rocco Cotilla. Next two kids I want to recognize. I don't think Sean's here, is he? Sean, no. The next two kids were a very important part of this football team. JC talked about the video we watched, and there's nobody's video that was better than Spencer Park's video. The championship video, he got a little sidetracked with the game. And but Spencer's been a part of this for a long time. Spencer, please come up. Last one I want to talk about, Sean Poacher, our statistician. Before I go too much farther, back a long time ago, I think it was 60, 70 years ago, Coach Dorman, when we had a pretty good year, he put together a cumulative stat sheet for the year. I still have that. I was talking to Coach Heather, or Mr. Hess about it, and he still has it. I have this for each one of you guys, okay? So I'm going to give this to you. It's one of those things that you put in your box of clippings or whatever, something that you can always look back on and remember the Titans. But anyway, next one. Our most honored opponent. We had some discussions about this, and this is something that means a lot to us, especially with this particular kid. He was as tough a competitor as we've ever seen, ever played against. But when it was over and he knew he was beat, what was he doing? Congratulating you guys. Patting you on the back. And I know for a fact he'd love to be playing with you. Because he said so. But I want to read a letter that is put together. I'm going to send this plaque, to Landers Smith. Flint Creek Titans, most honored and respected opponent, Landers Smith. Of course, it's in purple. It doesn't go well with greens, but we'll live with it. 2017 football, Charlotte Vikings. So I'm going to send this to Landers tomorrow, and it'll,
Enclosed will be this letter. Dear Landers Smith, congratulations. You have been chosen to receive the 2017 Most Honored Opponent Award. This award was announced at our football awards banquet on December 4th, 2017. This award is given annually to an opponent who, number one, exhibits outstanding athletic ability in the game of football, and number two, exhibits true sportsmanship. It is based on the idea that we can play a very intense, hard-hitting game and still come away feeling good about our opponent. You were first nominated and then selected through the team vote. Again, congratulations, and it has my name and the four coaches in the 2017 Flint Creek Titans. He's only a junior, and JC said, P.S., there's a bus ticket enclosed. Next ones are pretty important. This is our All-State academic. And in order to qualify for All-State academic, you have to have a 3.5 cumulative GPA or higher and receive a varsity letter. Now, granted, every one of our kids got a varsity letter because they deserved it. The first one goes to Spencer Park. By the way, we had 13 out of 22 players on this list. Pretty exciting. And by the way, JC and I never received this. So it's pretty cool. Alec Kaufman. Did you guys receive it? Cutler. Luke Holland. So this is where the mothers came in, right? Daniel Brayvender. Football coach at MSU?
I am.
What's his name?
Choate. Riley Trogdon. Kane Hess. You know, all the rest of these awards, that award is just as important, maybe more important. So great job in the classroom, guys. All Western Division. I want to talk to you about how this works. Coaches get together, and we nominate our own kids. I nominated every starter that we have, and rightfully so. You know, we clobbered everybody. And what happens after that is you can't vote for your own kids. You have to vote for your other, you know, the other kids on the list. So coaches nominate their own, and then the coaches, you know, talk about it, and then they hand in a ballot with numbers and stuff on it. So we have 14 people with all division teams. That's pretty good. I'll start with our youngest, sophomore Jackson Lee. Jackson was first team slot receiver, first team safety, first team punt returner. That's it. Jackson, I think you would have got kick returner, but no one kicked it to us.
Exactly.
Coach Piggy, yeah. We only had five or six returns all year. I wouldn't have kicked it to you either, bud. Luke Holland, first team outside linebacker. Colby Manley, second team running back, third team outside linebacker. Kane Hess, first team offensive line, second team defensive line. Riley Allen, first team tight end, first team defensive end. Andrew Gomez, second team center, second team defensive end. First team quarterback, first team inside linebacker, offensive player of the year, defensive player of the year. All state. You guys have seen it in the paper. We did pretty well for All-State. We had five of our starters All-State players. And that's a huge compliment to you guys, because there's only 34 for the entire state. So congratulations. Jackson Lee. Luke Holland. Riley Allen. Colby Manley. Colton Grange. Class C All-Star game that's been played since 1984. It's a huge honor to play in that game. It's a huge honor to coach. It's a huge honor to be anything a part of that game. Bob Clevenger was one of the great eight-man football coaches for a long, long time, and he started that game in 1984. I had the privilege of playing in it under Coach Todorovic. JC played in the game. It's one of those games that these kids will never forget. It's a week-long, awesome. Nate played in it. I know Nate played in it. Nate played the Shrine, too, did you?
No. Come on, man.
Anyway, these kids will never forget it. Andrew Gomez, Colton Gray. I just want to let everybody know that game's June 2nd in Butte. The banquet is the first in Butte. It's a great time. Please come and support these kids. You young guys, love to see you there, you know, to watch that game, and something that, as a goal for you to hopefully get to play in it. Now, for all the goodies. you're state champions. So you get a bunch of good stuff.
Yes.
So Gomez is excited. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through the roster again. What we're giving these kids is signed footballs. All the team members, coaches sign these footballs. They're getting this team picture that Mr. Allen, Tim, put together. It's a pretty cool picture. They're getting these medals from Montana High School Association. I have this is a stat sheet, and then I printed programs. These programs, these are the things that you'll always be able to look back on, show your grandkids and your children or whatever. So all these things, we're gonna and these banners. Here's the banner. By the way, this is what's going on the back of those state champion coats. Look at that little star. Drummond and Phillipsburg. Pretty cool. So
the star is back in the western part of the state.
It's going to stay there for a while. So, Preston, come up with your bowling shoes, bud. Kate Cutler. Jackson Lee. Colton Grange. Andrew Gomez. Thank you. Nate for sure. Daniel Raybender. Riley Trogdon. Quinn Rigby. Riley Allen. Alec Kaufman. Rocco Fertilla. Spencer Park. They ordered championship rings, the kids did, and hopefully they're going to be here. We're going to try and have give those to the kids when the Drummond Phillipsburg boys play basketball in Drummond on the 27th. So yeah, that could be a pretty special night. So hopefully they're here in time for that. Last thing that I want to go talk about is you know, we've been talking about the team. Team. Nothing but the team. And JC and I have talked about this at length, and we're not giving out individual awards. You were recognized by the coaches in your league. And as far as we're concerned, every one of you guys is an offensive and defensive MVP. Colton put in the throne for 1,600 yards if Kane and Rocco and Andrew and Riley weren't doing their job. Kobe couldn't have had the tackles that he did had, you know, the rest of you guys taking care of your business on the inside, so everything's spilled to the outside. So the only awards that we're going to give tonight is we're going to talk about our two captains. These two have been with us for 4 years. I remember when these, if you look at the team picture 4 years ago. We didn't know what we were going to do with Colton. Kid knew more about football than the coaches. But he was challenged. He had some growing to do. And look what he ended up being. Gomez, I thought he was in the third grade. Look what these two have become. The leaders that they've become. Captains of this team from the very get-go. The first four-year Titans. So I want to bring those two up and present them with these. This class, Flint Creek Titans senior captain Colton Grange, football state C eight-man champions. The last thing that I want to do, we want to do. The coaches and I have decided that we're going to give you seniors your jerseys, so come on up here. We're going to pay for them. And you guys deserve to take these home. They're going to get replaced. But congratulations, you deserve them. You can keep the ones that are on your back. And here's your wife. Oh, let's go. That's it, folks. I want to say again, thanks Jeff and Janet for coming and enjoying this special night with us. The rest of the fans, family, thank you for coming out and enjoying this. And thank you, Rock Creek, for having us out. I'm done.
I'd like to, you know, thank Steve and the Bonds for their hospitality tonight. Obviously, this has just been amazing. So, one more final applause for the Branch of Rock Creek Rabbit Club. Steve wanted me to talk to you guys briefly about a couple scholarships that they have here. There's two annual scholarships of equal value that will be awarded, one for the Branch of Rock Creek Hospitality Management and Culinary Arts Scholarship, and one for the Branch at Rock Creek Scholarship. Recipients can apply for this scholarship for their tuition bill in the fall, spring, or summer semesters. The recipient can opt to use the funds to help cover travel costs associated with a study abroad experience. And so then there's basically pretty small print, and I would have to use Mr. Cutler's glasses to read it, but I know that the first preference is for these recipients to be either from Brandon High School or Drummond High School. And I will make sure to send, I will get you a copy to bring this to Drummond High School. So, again, awesome football season, all the way around, everybody involved. Congratulations, state champions.
These are the two game balls, and they're going to go in trophy cases with the trophies. If you want to come up and touch the helmet, game balls are not going to get cleaned up. It was interesting because one of our normal game ball went flat, and we were accused of Tom Brady in the football. But anyway, both of these got played with. They're muddy, dirty, wouldn't want any other way. So here's the game balls. You want to come up and look at them as well. Please, family, don't forget to get the little trophy stuffed order forms. I did print some more of the stat sheets for family members if you want to come and get those as well. Thank you all for coming and enjoy the rest of the evening.